medicine and AI, does it make a difference in addressing cancer? Can doctors be robots or engineers or scientists? Or can robots, engineers, scientists become doctors? Rather, in this context, AI would fit augmented reality or augmented intelligence. By building an avatar with enhanced functionality of a doctor, scientist, engineer, and a robot. Now, I know what you're thinking. Kamala, we can't just hand over health to computers. Of course, you can't. But you can take their help, just like everything else in life. We can utilize computers and AI to improve patient care. Why don't we? Do we have a fear of something that will enable us to live a healthier life? Throughout my childhood, I lived in a house with 21 other people for 18 years. Strangely enough, I was the only one who ever had any health issues. It was as if a marksman hit on the board and my face was right in the center. Don't worry, I'm not bitter, but I do have a unique perception. I'm absolutely not bitter, which many of my family members don't even have. I was born with high myopia, as you see my eyeglasses. Sorry, a lot of reflection because of the type of the glasses I have, which means that I am nearsighted. So I can only see things which are nearby and I cannot see things at a distance. By the time I hit my preteens, it had got so worse that by the age of 11, I had minus 14 eyesight. I honestly can't believe how I studied, how I pursued so many advanced degrees and still pursuing lifelong learning about the advancements of human on Mother Earth. Looking back, I think it was a drive of passion and most importantly, curiosity. Curious George. So I'm very curious, always wanted to know more. And still wanting to know more, buried in books, buried now on my device or on my laptop, right? So picking the brain of, you know, all of these, you know, AI-enabled devices that we have at home, which we hear too many songs nowadays. Now, I would like to take a minute to talk about the struggle that really changed my entire perspective on life and how it connected me to many other struggles. Struggle in this case is that uncertainty, that phase of uncertainty, and many other uncertainties that I got connected to. It has been 10 years since I discovered that I have multiple sclerosis. With a 3.5-year-old in hand, I was hospitalized in the middle of the night, right around second week of September, 10 years ago, with stroke-like signs. A potentially disabling disease. It is called as multiple sclerosis or MS, and also Parkinson's like signs, where Michael J. Fox is very well known, the Hollywood actor, and he even established a Parkinson's Foundation. Kudos to his philanthropy. These diseases potentially disable your brain and also your movement disorders, and it's very hard to sometimes to even think appropriately and also to even walk, to sit, to balance. These are very debilitating diseases. Only 10% of the human brain knows. We know only 20% of what the human brain does. So you can imagine how tough it would be for any clinician or a doctor, and also scientists who are unveiling information. One of the most famous, you know, personalities in this field of astrophysics, Stephen Hawking, battled with similar scenario like in ALS. So it basically, there is a problem in these diseases where brain has issues in sending and receiving messages to and from the body. As a consequence of this painful journey, I now have an avatar of a universal patient champion attitude with an infinite dimension that has opened up in my battle for health. I don't want to live, why is this happening to me? But rather, I want to learn, what is this teaching me? And I want to share that journey with many patients like me or similar to me with unique conditions like cancer, who also have a multitude of signs like I battle, because many of the cancers have tremendous impact that you can see and you cannot see on the nervous system. Constant battle with pain. Through my advocacy activities, fifth year, I remember very clearly, I think it's like 2015 or 16-ish, where I started serving on cancer patient advocacy boards. And then I'm like, what? And being in the professional field as a scientist with pharmaceutical background and as an innovator in the diagnostics background, pardon me, my voice has issues, as you heard in the introduction, is I wanted to really feel and see what is the impact of healthcare innovation at the patient level through my patient journey as a scientist and as an innovator. You know, in this past 6 years, many instances and many experiences have shook my life, starting with my aunt. I was at the pinnacle of my career in cancer, having a huge knowledge and insight, not only as a clinician, but also as a scientist about the advancements of medical treatments, advancements of many treatments. You might have heard through COVID-19 pandemic, many of you, about clinical trial, right? How many years it takes for taking a novel sort of a solution or a thought about medical application into an approved treatment. It takes years. I lost my aunt in 2015, less than 9 months, lung cancer, never smoker, a beautiful person that I ever knew. Same thing happened to my niece 3 years ago, 7 years, brain cancer in less than a year. My friend, 40 plus, my neighbor's friend, people that I know, people that I don't know that I've met on flight, right? Or who have become my Facebook friend. Many of the cancer patients who have become, you know, good friends because of my advocacy activity. It is just entering in our lives in unprecedented ways. One very particular experience that shook me was the number of incidences I've been observing, how cancer biology is very unique in Caucasians versus African Americans versus Southeast Asians. I've seen a Southeast Asian mom lose her life at the age of 49 because the biology was so unique. The doctor had not a better understanding of the biology. And more recently in the news, Jaden, 13 years, all over the news in the United States, he lost his life to colon cancer. 13-year-old losing life. These are not cancers that you would see that are going by the textbook if I put my lens as a clinician. So there is a huge need how we need to change our mind shift about the way how we are traditionally practicing medicine in the context of cancer. It was very clearly evident through all these journeys that indeed, including when Jaden passed away 2 months ago, is, are we really able to understand the biology of cancer and many other diseases like mine in the right way? And also through all these experiences with my aunt, with my niece, with friends, with strangers, with patients, and including Jaden, it was very clearly evident that there was lack of access to information, lack of access to awareness of what needs to be done as early as possible. Would that be a test? Would that be access to treatments? Would that be access to trials at the right time? Because when you are switching from one treatment to other, there are many trials that are available, but clinical trials have a cumbersome criteria wherein you have only few weeks to get enrolled into trial and get accessible to that cutting edge treatment. A moment of gratitude. I really want to spend a moment, a second of gratitude for every cancer patient, every individual that has been impacted by illness. Lives that we lost, lives that are struggling. A moment of gratitude. You know what Jaden conveyed in his last moment words in a closed door discussion? Once again, we have permission to convey this. Is during his few days with technology, he realized beyond video games and football that he liked, that indeed, human body is like a video game and we really need to explore it further because doctors are not able to understand my biology. That's a powerful, powerful message to the field of medicine that could bring greater minds, passionate minds of a doctor, passionate professions, impactful professions of an engineer, of a robotic sort of experts, scientists. The definition of scientist is not just to biology, right? Anyone who can really think, analyze is a scientist. It can be a physicist, it can be a chemist, anyone. So cancer biology is becoming so complex, and we really need to build more and more insights and understanding. We also need to bring more awareness about cutting edge treatments, because 80% of the patients first go to a local doctor. I did in my case, and many in my case, including my aunt and Jaden, they are not going to go to a top-notch center, wait for months, because it advances so aggressively, many types of cancers. So really, information needs to be accessible as soon as possible. Technology can be enabled in such a creative way and a timely way that when a doctor is putting in information, really technology can guide about available treatments, available tests, because testing is so important. It's basically cancers, in the case context of cancers, no two cancers are the same. So field of medicine is going towards not one drug for all, right drug for the right patient. For that right drug or right even clinical trial to be accessible to the right patient, you also need to get tested at your DNA level. That's where we are going. The field of medicine is becoming from a telescopic view to a microscopic, and from a microscopic view to a telescopic application. We really need to look into ways how we really can communicate better and collaborate better. In many cancer cases, it's proving that lack of awareness, you know, is very much is one of the causes, lack of awareness of innovation. Innovation should be taken to the patient. Innovation should be taken to the physician, to the hospital system, and vice versa. Cancer trends taking away so many precious lives is a real moment of uncertainty. Applying one technology to the other is a no-brainer for us. For example, how many of us have cars, bikes, right? Electric scooters. We are able to drive better and experience better. Why can't we do the same in the field of our health outcomes? Why can't we really make our future of health much more hopeful, much more revolutionized with the insights of AI? I present to you AI, not as an artificial intelligence. It is a method of proving and enabling and adopting a unique perception, a unique ray of hope. The third eye and the fifth dimension of medicine, which is personalized or precision medicine. Basically, you basically treat patients based on DNA. Instead of treating every patient, you would actually go after right treatment based on the DNA, as I alluded. And it's not going after the textbooks, as I alluded in my earlier conversation. There is such a big future in healthcare, wherein it's almost exploring the cosmos of human anatomy. I just want to take a moment and appreciate our ancient healthcare innovators like Sushruta and Avicenna, who used the scientific and medical mindset for revolutionizing advancements in medicine hundreds of years ago, in some cases thousands of years ago. Sushruta was never just a surgeon. He was also an engineer in designing the most complex surgical instruments, the first plastic surgery ever designed on the nose, rhinoplasty. The best living example is Dr. James Allison, who got Nobel Laureate Award in 2018, unveiling a secret handshake mechanism that cancer was, you know, figuring out. And he figured out a path that you can use your own immune system to really address cancer. Cutting edge treatments, cellular therapies, gene therapies are now being designed. But the biggest problem is awareness. We not only have an opportunity through AI to understand biology, but also to adapt the treatments and trials and the tests. So AI has such a vast application. Scientists, engineers, doctors are now trying 24/7 for applying this mindset, collaborative mindset across not only in 200 types of cancers, but also in many debilitating diseases like mine, MS, ALS, Parkinson's, immune disorders, all of them. Disease diagnosis is a huge application. Robotic-assisted surgeries are a huge application in AI. COVID diagnosis using AI-based applications and X-rays was a game changer during the COVID-19 pandemic. predicting new treatments, automation of various medical applications, matching patients with trials. Patient engagement apps is so key because we're always in the mindset we are only the ones that are battling with this. But building that empathy and humanity through cancer patient engagement apps that I have experienced and I have leveraged it to many cancer patients, and also an MS engagement app in my case, wherein it would build more confidence and trust towards science and medicine. It really is a game changer. The world of healthcare can be made so more accessible through AI. For me, if we collaborate our professional abilities through the unique perceptions and advancements of AI, AI is authentic, audacious, augmentative, accelerative, and auspicious, like the five fingers of our hand, to make it uniquely functional. I want anyone listening to this to promise yourselves you will become more aware of the intelligence that we are making together, and more passionate, and pursue professions which are impactful, purposeful, of course, profitable. Everyone will make a profit in this, including our own health and also financial benefits. I want you all to pursue such cutting-edge professions by collaborating and leveraging the power of AI. In the next 5 to 10 years, the analysts are predicting a double-digit trillion-dollar global economic boom for AI researchers and colleagues. The combined power of science and innovation through AI can revolutionize medical advancements and save the lives of cancer patients, patients like me, and any uncertain health battles that I might face, you might face, anyone, your next door neighbor, anyone would face, and bring more hope and certainty. Certainty by understanding the disease biology better in the context of cancer patients, leveraging treatments at the right time, trials at the right time, educating at the right time, and making a certainty in their path towards health battle. Let us become the change we all want to see. Collaboration is a higher source of innovation. Let's augment our lives and the future of health with AI's silent revolution. Namaste.